Welcome to the Gig Garage. My name is Zach, and this is my fun little internet show about whitewater boating, rafting, kayaking, whatever. And today I want to talk about flipping a raft. And this is just a basic introduction to flipping a raft. There's some pretty cool advanced things you can do that I'm not going to talk about. This is a video for those of you that have probably never flipped a raft, even in practice, and are looking at doing class 3 and class 4 rivers where you could flip, and you need to know how to flip it back over. If you're going to advance in boating, this is just something you have to know how to do from a safety perspective. And so I'll talk about the basics, and it starts with just having practice. You need to do this on your own. Watching a video doesn't mean you can do it. So go to a pool, go to a flat area, go to like slightly moving water in a river, and practice flipping your raft. You need to do it a handful of times before you can actually do it in the field. Because when you fall out of the boat and the boat flips, there's an immediate like, I can't believe that just happened feeling. And you need to have this be kind of second nature, or you're going to kind of stumble your way down to get back in the boat and flip it back over. And I'm a member of the Oregon Whitewater Association, and last week they did a practice session at the pool, which was really cool. Members of the association are invited to do knot tying, cat flipping, raft flipping, anchor practice, mechanical advantage. And we were doing raft flipping drills in the pool, and that's a great way just to get some practice, to get a feel for it. Because there's a certain amount of timing and knowing how to lean back it takes to be able to do a really quick flip back over. And the basics of it are you typically want some sort of flip line. And this is the flip line I'm using now. It's the Blue Water something something streamer. I don't know. I'll put a link down in the show notes toward it where you can get one of these. But it's really nice because it's small, it's minimal. I put it now in the side pocket of my PFD, so it's always like quickly ready to go. Historically, I used a traditional flip line made out of 1-inch tubular webbing that I would wrap around my waist and attach with the locking carabiner. But that does, having something around your waist could potentially snag on something in a raft or on a log or something. So I'm trying to follow the clean line principle and get away from this. But this is also something I can stuff in my front life jacket. Some people on rivers where they might flip might put it under their PFD so they quickly get to it, whatever. But you need some sort of line that you take this carabiner, clip it to an external D-ring in the raft or something else. You can clip to other things possibly. And then lean back, holding onto the line, and then that flips the boat back over. So it's pretty straightforward. The hardest part of this whole thing is getting in the boat. So the trickiest part, actually, I mean, pretty much any of us can clip a carabiner on and lean back and get it over. The struggle is actually getting yourself from the river back into the boat. It's a physical fitness test. It's difficult. And when the boat's upside down, typically the easiest way to get up are on the ends. And so the ends are lowest in the water. You typically grab the end handle, pull your body up so your arm is straight, lock it out, reach for something in there, whether it's the floor lacing, a grommet, something, and just slowly pull yourself up like you're a beached whale. Some people are like ninjas. They're like 17 years old. They can jump up there really fast. Most of us, as we get older, it's hard. And you're putting your butt up in the air. It doesn't look pretty. It's just part of it. And it's something you have to practice. And you have to know if you can get in the boat or not. If you can't get yourself in an upside down boat, you probably shouldn't be guiding or taking people down difficult rivers where you could flip. Or if you are, you need to have somebody with you who's a ninja. Maybe there's like some 17-year-old with you that can jump in a boat and pull you in. You need to get a way to get back in. Some people have ladder systems. They carry in their PFDs, in their pocket, some sort of like ladder thing that they can clip on and use a step in the boat. It's a potential entrapment hazard, but also if it's in flat water, maybe you might think that's a good way to go. Some boats have things you can tie on the sides that unclip and they make ladders so you can get back in. So these are just considerations, because getting in that upside down boat is incredibly hard. And it's something that, again, if you're approaching 3+, 4, 5 rivers, especially high water continuous, you need to know that you or one or more people with you can get back to that boat and back in it. So, you know, you climb up the end, it's difficult. You get on the upside down boat, you pull it over with your flip line, and then you need to get back in the boat on the side. So when the boat's right side up, you don't want to get on the ends because they're sticking up. You want to jump in and get on their sides. And it's the same deal. You know, you grab a handle or grab your danger rope around the outside, pull yourself up so an arm is straight, reach for something in the boat. Thwart handles are really good for this if you have thwart handles, and then you can kind of pull yourself up. But it's physically difficult to do that as well. So again, that's the most difficult part. And again, this is how it goes. You're guiding a raft, whatever you're doing, it flips. You have a moment of like, holy cow, that just happened. But you need to get over that quick, swim to the end of the raft, get up there. It's tough, especially if there's waves and the boat's moving. If it's flat water, it's one thing, but when the waves are going, it's another thing. Get yourself up there, take your flip line, your handy flip line, clip it to a D-ring or something on the boat, lean back, flip the boat back over, then swim back to the boat and use the danger rope around the outside or a handle to get yourself back in and then start pulling people back in the boat. It's a process, it's a physical fitness test, and it's something that you need to practice to be able to do second nature. The other thing is oar boats flip too. Cataracts, oar boats flip, and that creates another issue, which are the oars. And so I'd recommend, if you can, pull the oars off. When the oars are upside down in the water, and you try to reflip, they might hit things underwater. And when the boat flips, the oar might smack you in the head or the leg or something. And so it's a potential danger when you're flipping the boat back over. So, you know, when I'm in a hurry, if I'm in between two big rapids and I flipped, I'll do a quick reflip with the oars on, but be really careful when the oars are coming over. But if I can, I'll get the boat in a flat spot or to shore, and I'll pull the oars off and then reflip the boat. And there's ways you can flip the boat on shore. You could also have a friend pull you into their raft and then put you on top of your raft. There's a bunch of advanced techniques, but this is the basic deal for flipping boats back over. So that's it. The most important thing, again, I just want to reiterate, because this is, I want to make these points. One, practice. You have to practice this, not just once. Do 10 flips, do a couple a year, practice it a bunch. And two, getting it back in the boat is the hard part. And so there is some physical fitness to doing this that's important. So that's it. If you have any questions, as usual, add comments. Those of you that are flipping boats all the time, that do this all the time, that have expertise, I'd love to know what you think. I'd love to hear some advanced comments down in the comment section below. It's a super interesting topic. And yeah, thanks for joining me. See you next time.